My first piece is a print, and the whole symbolism of the piece, my body of work centers around the theme of space, and for this piece I wanted to show empty space, which I associate with isolation. So for this piece I wanted to depict a bird, kind of symbolizing the human spirit, which is isolated, which is why it's by itself in the center of the page. And in isolation I feel as though we as humans kind of explore our various sides, and in this piece the sides that are depicted are the creative side and the dark or mechanical side, and that's represented by the gears, and the creative side is represented by the moving lines. Overall, I just wanted, for as far as composition goes, I really wanted the focal point to be in the center of the page, despite many people not liking that, but I felt as though it was important in embodying isolation and aloneness. Second piece is a loop of the first piece, and it's a metals piece, and it's actually a pin. And for this piece, I wanted to focus on more of the mechanical side, and I really wanted to express the feel of the mechanical side or the dark side, which is why I made it in metals, because metal is cold and metal is essentially heartless. So for this piece I did two large gears, and then I also soldered a bird on top of the gears to also just show again the human spirit as represented by the bird.
I was inspired by William Stewart Sitting Bull, who was an artist who he is known for, at least in my personal opinion, I love him because how he highlights and uses shadows with bright colors. And so for this piece, he uses a lot of Native American culture as well. So for this piece, I decided to do a Native American style. And basically what this is representing is the respect for nature and how everything has a spirit within it. So in the smoke, you can see a form of a wolf at the bottom and then an eagle at the top, and basically representing the spirits that live within nature.
This is a self-portrait painting I did in acrylic, and I really like nature, so I went with a mountainous background because I love mountains. And I'm also drawing in this picture because I love drawing and I'm drawing a lot. I kind of went with like a bored expression because I find myself drawing in class a lot out of boredom, especially in like that kind of pose. This is an abstraction of a flower. It's not quite done, but I did it with soft pastels, and I used complementary colors, my favorites, which are purple and green. And then I also used yellow.
This piece really symbolizes women's oppression in Africa. The city or little town behind in the background symbolizes the control of men and society has over women, and how the woman in this piece is looking out beyond of what should be or could be in her society. This piece is of pastel chalk.
For this piece, I chose to incorporate the progression of time, and I started off with a linoleum print, in which is visible in the bottom right hand corner with the clock tower, and I really focused on bringing out the clock face of the Big Ben Tower itself, and the numbers on the front are three-dimensional. I cut them out. The background itself was painted black to start, and then paint splatters were used as, paint splatters are seen more in modern works. Focusing on the progression of time, I wanted to keep the time frame itself ambiguous, so in doing so it gives sort of a nostalgic feel to it with the paint splatters, because it goes against the very straight and strict lines used throughout the rest of the piece, and so being a more modern technique, it goes along with that time period.
It's part of a series I did on sleep, regarding the theme on which my body of work centralizes, which is necessity. Near the beginning of the year, I chose a specific topic, which was sleep, and began exploring a new medium at the same time, which would be printmaking, which requires the use of printing inks, ink brayers, something I've just recently got into, which was silk screening, which requires a screen and pushing it through that. This is almost all using ink blocks, and it's a summary of the past three sleep works that I did on sleep, which was sleep 1, 2, and 3. There's a lot of symbolism involved with it, as well as commentary on what sleep is and how it affects us.
This painting doesn't really have a lot of symbolism. I just decided to do the self-portrait in my room because my room is very important to me, obviously. I'm sure it is to a lot of people, but I spent a lot of time in there. And I used acrylics to paint it. And in the background is other paintings that I've done. So I thought that'd be kind of good for symbolism, you know, on the wall, just kind of show what I like to do.
I originally created it because I was inspired by the artist Mark Jenkins. He was a street artist, and he creates like groups of tape people, and he kind of puts them in streets all over the world. And they're really creative, and I thought it was a lot of fun. And this is supposed to depict a fisherman, and I picked this specifically because my body of work concentrates on the theme of childhood and maturity and growing up. And as a child, fishing with my father was always kind of a big thing, and I feel like a lot of kids like have this experience also, so this was my inspiration. To make this piece, I wrapped myself in saran wrap and then used clear packaging tape to make it more sturdy, and then you just cut it off yourself and you retape the seams and it stays in the same shape.
This is a tri-piece series. It shows a maple tree growing in a pot, and on the pot there shows the process of maple syrup being made, starting with the collection of sap and then the boiling of it over fire, and then showing it in a maple syrup jar. The background shows a industrialized area with a highway and then a factory, and as the tree grows, the factory is covered up by its leaves. This shows that nature is shutting out the pollutants and the other cities that man has made over time. I used acrylic paints to make this.
These are three pieces from my art portfolio, metal specifically. The first piece to the left was a ring that I fabricated with nickel silver. I constructed it during my sophomore creative metals class, and I was inspired to do it because I wanted to try something challenging and something with personal meaning to me. First created a band ring, and with that I attached a collar, then filed it out to smooth it around the finger. After that I sized up acrylic plastic, the blue color you see specifically, and I inlaid that around the ring, which involved bending it by heating it and filing it to smooth it out. Next, I also inlaid wood, which also involved carving. And lastly, I inlaid a stone in the center by bezel setting. And after polishing and filing it up, it is what it is now. I was inspired to do it mainly for personal reasons. I like the blue. It was more to motivate emotional reflection. For me, when I look at the blue, it kind of calms you down and causes you to reflect on one's integrity or morals. So it was more personal meaning for trying to be as pure, I guess, as I can be. The second piece was inspired by my mother. I wanted to create a piece that represented her. And first thing that came to mind was the sea. It's powerful yet calm and almost like a guide to many.
I started off by carving a wax with it, which I used to create a mold. And with that, I cast it in silver. After that, I inlaid stones within it, polished it up. I also decided to antique it to give it more of a affected metal. It is supposed to be an abstract representation of a fish with the scales shown by the grinded scales around it, and it carries the general shape of a fish. I chose it because I saw that fish were very mystique creatures, and also they were part of the sea, and I felt that represented what I was trying to embody with the piece. Lastly, the piece to the right, I constructed with copper wire and copper sheet metal. I folded it around and twisted it, and my inspiration was a Celtic vine. After researching it and researching the symbolism behind it, that it represented a sense of growth, and mainly I read that it also symbolized that if you're who you are, essentially, you're going to achieve the best that you can be. So I wanted to put the stone in there to show like the inner part of you, with the blue hole in the center to show that inner soul almost, and the general shape of the piece represents that.